Hi, good morning guys. Class 6, how are you all doing? Great to see you again. So you must be very surprised to see me on Friday. Friday, I guess you get your English classes also. So today I'm going to do your SST. And English also you'll get it. I guess I'll be only doing a story with you for English. So I don't know if Kumar sir is available or not. I actually don't know. So I've been given the responsibility. So I'll come back later with the English one story I'm going to explain today, and let's see what we can do. So I'll just start reading for you, and we'll finish this chapter today of this Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa, the Indus Valley civilization, and then we'll go to the age of Vedas slowly. So I'll read in the first video, I'll just read it for you. In the second video, I'll go and explain it to you actually what happened for the decline of this total Harappan thing. I have explained the earlier one. We were till Baluchistan, if I'm not mistaken. I was explaining you about the extent, you know, how far did it flourish, and why people started. There were more population growing. Excuse me, population was growing, and suddenly people started moving out from the river areas. Water was becoming scarce. Natural calamities were too much, so they were trying to go inside the city, towards the city, and closed houses. They were staying with animals, and at the same time, disease was also flowing. This may be the causes of the decline of the Harappan culture, which went down. Drains were clogged in during rain. The drains were getting blocked. No one was there to clean it. So this is all what was happening. And Harappan cities in Gujarat. Is Lothal. Lothal is a coastal site. Like the other sites, it was divided into a citadel and a lower town. A large warehouse has been found, which was perhaps used to store goods. I have told you this earlier also. Other significance includes bead factory. Yes, I have done this. I have read this for you. So that's not a problem. Dholaveya, and yes, the Bengal part also I have told you. We'll do from Dholavira. Dholavira lies in the Khadir Islands of Rann of Kutch. It is locally known as Kotwada. In terms of size, it is one of the largest Indus Valley settlements in India and the fifth largest of the sites that have been discovered so far. It is famous for its magnificent town planning. Excavations first began here in 1990 and are still on. Dholavira was different from the other cities in that it was divided into not two but three parts: a citadel, a middle town, and a lower town. Many graves, I have told you about this town system which happened: the citadel, the middle town, the citadel, and the lower town. Many graves have been found here, the excavated graves containing pottery and jewelry. Dholavira is famous for another thing, perhaps the oldest signboard in the world, containing 10 large-sized signs of the Harappan script. Has been found here. This is unique because all other samples of Harappan writing are available only on seals. So, what do you think actually was on that signboard? Something must have been there. Let's see if that signboard is given. The picture of the signboard is not given anywhere. I'll arrange a picture and show it to you. So, Goladhoro is a recently excavated site in Kutch region, that's in Gujarat area, Rajasthan. Rajasthan, Gujarat, the Rann of Kutch, where the water comes into the land. Excavated articles suggest articles of shell and copper were produced here. Many finished and unfinished shell bangles have been found here. A unique seal has also been found. It is shaped like a box and is hollow. You can see the picture on page 26 of that. Seal box, which is there with a hollow. Here it is, the hollow seal, Goladhoro. About 3500 years ago, there was a big change in life of the Harappan people. The number of people living in the cities became less. Overseas trade stopped. Instead of baked bricks, sun-dried bricks began to be used for constructions. The houses became less impressive. In Mohenjo-Daro, the drains were choked and garbage got piled up on the street. We do not know why this was happening, but something was wrong. A general decline had perhaps begun, but specific causes must have different from city to city. they may have been natural disasters such as earthquakes, floods, epidemics, or change in the course of river Indus. Whatever the reason, archaeological evidences suggest that people abandoned the cities and moved to smaller settlements. This is how this whole thing went down about the Indus Valley civilization. Okay guys, we are clear with this. So A and B is your job, C and D is my job, right? Okay, I'll do that. Give short answers of the following, long answers are my job, true and false is yours, and tick the correct answers is your job. I'll not tell you anything, you have to read the chapter and do it yourself. I know you'll be able to do it. In the Indian subcontinent, the first cities emerged in the valley of River Ganga, River Satluj, River Indus, River Chenab. It's River Indus. The civilization flourished between, you must give that time, 2500 to 1500, 1500 to 1000, 3500 to 3500 to 1500 BCE, 2000 to 2000 BCE to 2000 CE, wrong. So the dash cut each other at right angles, streets, houses, seals, streets. Mud and hay, mortar and cement, sun-dried bricks, baked bricks. Used were concerned to mortar and mud and hay, sun-dried bricks, baked bricks. Now, mortar and cement, I guess, sun-dried bricks, baked bricks, baked bricks. Or, I don't know, you have to do it for yourself. I'll not tell you the answer. In Mohenjo-daro, the largest building is the granary, lower town, great bath or dockyard, that you have to do. Most of the seals made of bitumen, terracotta, most of the seals are made of bitumen, terracotta, tar and stone. Terracotta, I guess. Trading links with dash have been proved by the discovery of Mesopotamian seals in Harappan cities, Mesopotamia. Okay. So the script of the Harappans was Roman, Brahmi, Latin, pictographic. Pictographic, true or false? Archaeological sources are the main source for studying the Harappan civilization. Absolutely correct. Most Indus cities were well planned. Okay, Great Bath lies in citadel. Wrong. The Harappan script has been deciphered. Wrong. Dholavira lies in Khadir Islands in the Ran of Kutch. Now that is right or wrong? It is right. That's up to you. And then I have what is the Indus Valley civilization known as and why? How do we know the most Indus cities were well planned? How Dholavira differed from Indian other cities? I'll give you this. This is my job. Okay, so you don't have to worry. By Saturday it will be there on the Saturday or Monday, last to last on Monday. It will be put up for you. Okay, very good. So now we are going to go to the, we have done four chapters here. Why don't we do something in geography, or rather let's go to a chapter page 84. Okay, we'll go to the Earth and the solar system. Wow, that's going to be quite good. Earth and the solar system, page 84. Okay, the Earth and the solar system. What is all about our mother Earth and the solar system? It's going to be quite interesting. So, the Earth and the solar system on page 84. Okay, so let's start. Since ancient times, I'm going to read first and after that I'm going to explain, or I can if I explain first then you won't be able to get enough of it, so I might miss out something. So first I'll read whatever we read, that's what I'm going to explain to you as per in the book, and I'll give it in a more elaborated way. Okay, so fine, let's start. Since ancient times, people have looked at the shining objects in the sky and wondered why do some of them twinkle. what holds them up there, how they are out there, how they're holding up. Why is the sun visible during the day while at night we see numerous dots of light? Why do we see the moon increasing and decreasing in size? All objects which we see in the sky are called heavenly bodies or celestial bodies. The heavenly bodies include the stars, planets, satellites, asteroids, comets, and meteors. Our Earth is also a heavenly body. The word universe stands for everything that exists in the space, Nobody knows exactly how the universe was formed. It probably originated 2000 crore years ago due to a Big Bang. It is difficult to understand the vastness of the universe. The universe has countless number of galaxies. Our sun and all stars that you see in the night sky belong to this galaxy. It is called the Milky Way galaxy or the Akash Ganga. This galaxy has about 10,000 crore stars. Okay. It is difficult to derive a unit for measuring the distance between variously heavenly bodies in the universe as they are very far from each other. Astronomers do not use the ordinary units of measurement such as miles or kilometers. Instead, they normally use a unit called the light year. Okay, so I'll come back in the next video and I'll give the explanation till where I have read. I'll go slowly. So suddenly from history to geography we are coming. It's going to take your time to settle down into it. So don't worry, I'll take care of it. I'm there. So I'll come back in the next video. Okay.